Hello everyone, today we will see lab program 6B of design and analysis of algorithms laboratory. The aim of the program here is to write a program in Java that implements the knapsack problem using greedy method. In order to implement the program for the same, we will have to have a brief description with respect to what is a knapsack problem and how exactly the knapsack problem is being solved using the greedy method, and then followed with the program. So here actually in the greedy method technique, the knapsack problem, the type of the knapsack problem that we are now dealing is fractional knapsack problem. What is a knapsack problem? So you can just see here in the diagram or in the figure, knapsack problem is nothing but the process of placing the objects into a knapsack or a bag which has got certain capacity, such a way that the items that are filled into the knapsack will give me the maximum value or the profit, and it should not exceed the capacity of the knapsack. So we can observe here, the bag here is now made up of 15 kilos. And we have certain items surrounded to it, wherein each item associates some weight, right? And also with some profit if I place the object into my knapsack. So let us see how exactly the problem is now being dealt. So the problem of knapsack is just placing these objects into the knapsack such a way that I will not exceed the capacity of the knapsack, and also I'll get the optimal profit or maximum profit by placing the objects into the knapsack. So let us have a brief description of the strain with respect to the problem statement. We have the problem statement of the fractional knapsack tells that there are n objects which are given to us with weight W of I and a profit P of I, and also given a knapsack of total capacity M. Some capacity is given. The problem here is now, as I said, to pack or fill the knapsack with these objects in order to provide total value or the profit of those objects packed without exceeding the knapsack capacity. So more formally, when I go for a programming aspect, I need one more variable which denotes me the fraction of the object I. So you have a x of I. So what is this x of I denoting? What is the fraction of the object I that is included in your knapsack? As the name indicates, it is a fractional knapsack problem. Fractional knapsack problem means I can place the object completely or in terms of fraction. So there are three ways of placing the object into the knapsack. First is there is complete placement of the object into the knapsack, or a partial placement, or the object may not be placed. The three status with respect to an item. So x of I, the value x of I denotes the so we need to find x of I, that is the fraction of the object I to be included in the knapsack. So this I, x of I denotes the fraction of the object that must be included, where I denote it by the values 0 and 1. So 0 indicates it is not included, no fraction is included. 1 indicates it's completely included, and any fraction between 0 to 1 indicates the fraction of which has been included. So for example, if I tell x of I is 0.5, 50% of the object is included into the knapsack. So this x of I ranges from 1 to n. So 1 means to say from first object to the nth object. The problem here is now basically to find the values for the x of I. So given me the weight, the profit and the capacity, I'll have to find the values of x of I. So if a fraction x of I of the object I is being placed in my knapsack or the bag, a profit of P of I into x of I is made. Why I write the statement P of I into X of I? Because whenever we have fraction of the profit is only obtained, so not complete profit. 50% is stored in my knapsack of the item, so I'll get 50% of the profit. That's what it means to say P of I into X of I. So the objective here that we have seen is to place the objects such that I get maximum profit. So it is not simply placing, I have to get the maximum profit here. If not possible to include an object entirely, we can place fraction, which I said, and fraction of the profit is earned. So mathematically, we can now just give a statement. I need to maximize summation of P of I into X of I, where I ranges from 1 to n, first object to the last object. So I'll have to summate all the profits obtained by including the objects, checking for the inclusion of the objects into my knapsack. Okay, summated such that summation of W of I into X of I is less than or equal to M. That means to say the capacity of the knapsack should not be exceeded. So when I place the objects into my knapsack, the capacity of the knapsack must not be exceeded. The summation of all the weights of the objects that are placed into the knapsack should be less than or equal to M. That's what it means. For every object X of I ranges from 0 to 1, right? And I ranges from 1 to N. So as we all know that, we've discussed this, the knapsack problem, fractional knapsack problem is solved by using the algorithm design technique called as greedy method. So we also know that in greedy method, we get two kinds of solutions. First solution is feasible solution, the other one is the optimal solution. And also, we follow certain strategies to solve any problem which is based on greedy method. What is a feasible solution? A feasible solution is a solution which satisfies the conditions of a problem. So what is the condition here? I'll have to place the objects into the knapsack such that the capacity of all the objects placed in the knapsack does not exceed the knapsack capacity. But along with that, I should also make sure I should get one constraint or one objective to be achieved. I should get maximum profit, isn't it? So the optimal solution and the feasible solution are the two solutions here. So feasible will be placing any object into the knapsack, not worried about the profit. But optimal is a solution where we place the objects in the knapsack such a way that we get maximum profit. So in order to get the optimal solutions, there's a lot of strategies which are applied to arrive at the optimal solution. So the first strategy which is used is greedy about profit. So we select the objects greedy. We are greedy about the profit. We select the objects in the descending order of profits. The second strategy is greedy about the weight. We select the objects in terms of ascending order of weights. The third strategy is greedy about profit by weight ratio. So all the strategies when we apply, we get some solution, and all the solutions are the feasible solutions. All the solutions are feasible. Out of which the third strategy now gives me the optimal solutions. The third strategy is a one which now gives me the optimal solution. So this strategy gives us the optimal solution. So you should be very, very precise. So this gives us the optimal solution for my problem. That means to say, places the objects into the knapsack such that we get maximum profit. So using this strategies, now we will go to the program. So the program for the same looks like this. So I'll first import the package. So I've just imported the util package and a specific class I've imported is a scanner class. So I've declared one class called as a fractional class. So in this program, we have only one class. So not more classes. In a single class only, we have the methods and along with that main method too. So fractional knapsack. So declared some of the data members here. There are five data members you can see. So weight, profit, ratio, all the three are the arrays. which will hold the weights of the objects, which will hold the profits of the objects, and which will hold profit by weight ratio of the objects. And the fourth one is a cap, which represents the knapsack capacity, and n items gives the number of items or the objects here. So I have five data members. So you can see here, I have just declared the arrays. So I have to initialize them, or I'll have to allocate the memory, right? So I'll allocate the memory when I read the number of items. Based on the items, I will allocate the memory. As of now, they're just arrays are being declared, stating that weight is an array of type double. Profit is of type double, ratio is of type double, right? So I've used double here so that the values won't get vanished. So if I use int, the floating point values will be vanished. So be careful if you use double here. Next is here, I'm declaring some of the methods inside my class. One is fractional knapsack. You can observe it is same name as that of the class. So this is a constructor. The second method which I am using here is getNext, the second method. The third method is fill method. The last one is your main method. So there are four methods. One is constructor, the other two normal methods, and the other one is a main method. So four methods are there. Let us see how it is this constructor doing. So as the name indicates, constructor will initialize the data members. So what am I trying to do? Let's see. So first I'll create scanner class object. So scanner, scan is equal to new scanner system.in. So I'm creating a scanner class object to read the inputs from the user. System.out.println, I'm just printing a message. So I'm trying to solve a greedy method knapsack problem solved using greedy method. The next, I'll ask the user to enter the number of items in the store, which will be scanned and placed it in n items. So n items is equal to scan.next int. So it is an integer. So I'm writing using the next int method. And next, I will read the profit and the weights of the items together. So you should be very careful reading of weight and profit together. So together I'll have to write. For every object, I'm reading weight followed with this profit of the items. Okay. So before I start reading, I should initialize or allocate the memory for the arrays. So I'll just use this statement. You can see weight is equal to. So already I have told weight is an array. Now what should I do? I should allocate the required amount of memory based on n items. So weight is equal to new double in square brackets n items. Similarly, I'll declare profit. Similarly, I'll declare ratio. So all these are of size based on n items, right? And then in order to read the elements into the array, I need a for loop. So inside the for loop, can you see I'm reading now weight first and then the profit, right? So you can see for int I equals to 0, I less than n items I plus plus, right? Or plus plus I, doesn't matter much difference there. Weight of I equals to scan dot next double. Profit of I equals to scan dot next double. Why? Because next double is of type double there. And after I read profit and weight, immediately I'm even calculating the ratio. What does ratio hold? Profit by weight entity. The ratio of I is equal to profit of I divided by weight of I, right? And that ends the for loop. So you can now see here, I index starts from 0 to n items. So what is my n items in my case? So n items is equal to 3. If I take an example, n items is equal to 3. So the index starts with 0, 1, 2, right? The array index starts with 0, 1, and 2. Three elements. Okay. So whatever I enter weight, it will be stored, followed with the profit, and then it will calculate the ratio and it stores. Similarly, 15, 24, its ratio. 10, 15, its ratio of 1.5. So this has been done by the compiler automatically when you enter weight and the profit. So you should be careful. First, you should enter weight and then the profit. Then ask the user to enter the capacity of the knapsack. So he will enter the capacity and that gets stored in cap. So cap is now having, as a illustration, it is having a capacity of 20. This is one part of the illustration there. So remember, weight profit ratio, they are all the arrays here. Then we have another method called as a get next method, which returns an int value. So we will see what get next does the next slide. And similarly, I have a fill method, which returns void, doesn't return anything. And followed with that, I have the static void main method. What is the static void main method doing? It is creating an object of the fractional knapsack class and calling the method fk.fill. So you can now see, so fill is nothing but a method that places my objects into my knapsack. So you can give any name. I have given fill. So you can give pack as a name, or you can give anything you can give, pack or full, right? Anything gives up, but I have given it as a fill, fk.fill. So this is a method which will now place the objects into my item, right? So, and this is the end of my class fractional knapsack. The forthcoming slide, we'll now see what are these two methods doing for me. So fill method, as I said, fill is a method which will now fill the knapsack with the objects. So you should be clear in your theory classes that when I take profit by weight ratio, how do we select the objects? So we select the objects based on decreasing order of profit by weight ratio. Means to say, whichever object has got highest profit by weight ratio, we select the object first and keep placing in the knapsack, right? Till I am able to place it completely. But once I feel that I cannot place the object completely, and then I'll go for the fractional part of the object to be placed. And actually, when I deal with this kind of a program or a problem, usually the fraction part will be your last object. That means to say your knapsack is full, then only you will go for your fraction part. Otherwise, you keep placing the objects completely. Let us see how exactly it is programmed. So currently, I will use two variables here, CW and CP. What is CW and CP, which are initialized to zero, which is of type double? Current weight of the knapsack, current profit of the knapsack. So what is the current weight, current profit of the knapsack? That means to say, when I keep placing the objects into the knapsack, right, the weights of those objects is my current weight, and the profit that I earn is my current profit. Okay, so initially I have not placed any objects into the knapsack, so current weight is zero, current profit is also zero. Fine. Next is, I am declaring one array, x array. So as I told you, x indicates what? The fraction of the objects which are placed into my knapsack. So this is also of type double. X is an array which is of size n items. That is 3. In our example, it is 3. Now, I will fill the knapsack with the objects or the items until it exceeds the capacity. Until it exceeds the capacity, I'll have to fill the knapsack. So let us see how it is filling. So I have this table for my reference there. You can now see the X array is of size what? N items. So 3 elements it has, whose index starts with 0, 1, and 2. Since I have not initialized, you know, in your Java program, it gets automatically initialized to 0. So values of x0 is 0, x1 is 1, and x2 is also 0 there. Okay. Let us see now how exactly the procedure goes. So while I've used a iteration statement there. Current weight while CW is less than cap. So you know what is cap in the previous example? Cap is equal to 20. So we have cap equals to 20. Is current weight less than or equal to cap. Okay, so what is my current weight here? You can see the current weight currently is now zero. Yes, currently it is zero. Is zero less than 20? Yes, the condition is true. I've still not placed any objects into my knapsack. So current weight is zero. Zero is zero less than 20? Yes, I can place objects into my knapsack. Condition is true here. So it enters the while loop. And inside the while loop immediately, I'll call a function so called as getNext. So we'll go to the code of the getNext sometime later. But right now, just understand getNext is a method which gives me the index of the item which has got the max ratio. It gives the index of the item which has got the max ratio. That index will be returned by getNext. Okay. Now you can see in this table which item has got the max ratio. You can see the max ratio is 1.6, and this is my second item whose index is what now? 1. The index is now what? 1. So item, under item, I'll now have the value 1. Why? Because it is max ratio is 1.6, isn't it? So I should get the index of that particular item which has got maximum ratio. So it is 1. Right? So getNext returns a value called as 1 into the item. So item is equal to what now? 1. If item is equal to minus 1, it indicates. So in the method getNext, we have made some convention. We'll see that later. If item is equal to minus 1, if item is getting a value of minus 1, it is understood that there are no more items. Break out, come out of the loop, break the loop. If not, so in our case, you can see item is equal to 1. So you come to the next line. So if here I am just checking current weight, I'm not adding it, but I'm just checking, is the current weight plus weight of the item. So what is weight of the item? What is item to me? Index 1. If 0 plus weight of 1. So what is weight of 1? So weight of 1 is what? 15. Can you see? Weight of 1. So 0 plus 15 is less than or equal to 20. Yes, it is true. What am I checking here? I'm just checking whether I can place the item which I got through getNext into the knapsack completely. That's what I'm checking here. Means I can place it. If current weight plus adding the item, okay, is less than or equal to cap, I can place the object completely. No harm. Yes, so I can place the object there completely without any issues. Next, if it is, this is true, enter the if statement, and I should update what? The current weight and the current profit, because I'm placing the object completely. Which object I'm placing? The object which is at the index 1. Index 1, which is that object at index 1. That is my second object. Remember, index 1 is second object. Okay, update the current weight. So what is the current weight now? Initially it was what? Initially it was 0. So updated with 0. 0 is my current weight plus weight of the item. That is weight of 1. So that is equal to 0 plus, what is the weight of 1? Weight of 1 is 15. 0 plus 15 is equal to 15. That means to say, now the current weight is equal to how much? 15. That means the one object is into my knapsack. No problem. What is my current profit? So I placed which object into my knapsack? Item 1 is placed into my knapsack, whose profit is what? 24. And it is completely placed. So again, you can see current profit will now become 24. 0 plus 24. Current profit is 24, right? Then ratio of item equals to 0. What I do is, I will mark this item's ratio as 0. Means to say, I should not use this again for the next function, get next function. So I will mark this ratio of item as 0. So the ratio of item was 1.6. I'll now mark it as 0. The reason, because if I don't mark this again as 0, next iteration also get next will be the same highest value. In the next iteration, you know that get next should get the second highest ratio, isn't it? Should not get the same value. Just to avoid that or tell that it is done. Selection is already done. So ratio of item, I'll initialize it back to 0. Then I should update something called as x of item. And x of item equals to 1 because I have completely placed. How do I know that it is completely placed? Know that 0 plus when I add it to my current weight, it should be less than or equal to the capacity. It is placed. So x of item, what is item to me? 1. X of 1 is now 1. It has been completely placed. No harm. Right? Then there is an else block also. So anyways, if is followed with the else, if is true, it executes if block. If is false, it will execute else block. So right now, else block will not be executed. Again, it goes back to while. Let us see what happens in while. Now, what is current weight? Earlier it was 15. Now current weight is what now? 15. Earlier it was 0, sorry. Now the current weight now becomes what? 15. Is 15 less than 20? Yes. There is sufficient space in my capacity. I can still put some objects. True. Again, select the next object which has got the highest ratio. Now you can see which is the next object which has got the highest ratio. It is my third object. Third object whose ratio is 1.5. So you can now see if this was again 1.6, you could have selected this. Right now, that's not the case. So it will select now 1.5. 1.5's index value is what? It is 2. So get next returns the index value, so called as 2. Item now becomes 2. Is item equals to minus 1? No. Comes down here. To if statement. If 0 plus 15. Earlier it was 0. Now it is not. 0. What is the current weight now? You can see current weight is 15. You can see the current weight. Current weight is what? 15. So 15 is 15 plus what is the weight of item 2? The index 2. You can see what is the weight at index 2? What is the weight? 10. Yes. 15 plus 10. Is it less than or equal to 20? 15 plus 10 is how much? 25. 25 is no more less than or equal to 20. The condition is now what? False. Condition is now false. It becomes false. Isn't it? You can see now the condition no more satisfied. What will I do? The condition doesn't satisfy. See, I cannot place completely, but I can place fraction. And when I come to the point where I can place only the fraction, that is the end of the selection process, isn't it? So how do I do now? Let us see. So it immediately now goes to the else block. So if is associated with the else block, can you see the else block here? Else. When does this else execute? Whenever current weight plus weight of the item will become greater than the capacity of the knapsack. In this case, you will have to take fraction selection. So how do you take fraction? So what is now x of item? X of item is nothing but remaining capacity, as I told you. What is the remaining capacity? The original capacity of the knapsack minus the current weight of the knapsack. Can you see? Original capacity of the knapsack minus the current weight of the knapsack. So what is the original capacity of the knapsack? Original capacity here is, what is the original capacity? Original capacity here is, now in the example, 20. Currently now I have 15, right? So what is that I get? So remaining capacity is 5. 5 divided by weight of the item. So weight of the item is how much now? 10, isn't it? So weight of 2, if you can go back, you can see weight of 2 is how much? 10. Here it is. Weight of 2 is 10, right? Weight of 2 here is 10, isn't it? So what should I do? So I should now get the fraction. So x of item. So what is this x of item? X of 2 is nothing but now 0.5. Isn't it? 1 by 2, that is 0.5. Half I can select. Out of 10, I can place only 5 units of the object. So item is now partially selected. So how do you get the fraction? Remaining capacity by the weight of the item. So how do I get the remaining capacity? Original capacity of the knapsack minus current weight of the current weight of the knapsack. Right. So now update the profit and the weight back again. So when I take profit, currently the profit was what? Currently the profit, earlier the profit was what? 24, right? So 24 is my profit. Earlier it was 24 plus, so I have written CP plus equals to. So whatever is CP, add something to it. That's what it means. Compound assignment operators. CP is equal to CP plus X item into profit of item. That's what I mean. So what is X item here? 0.5. Fraction I am taking 0.5 into profit of the item. So profit of 2. What is profit of 2? 15. Right? Profit of 2 is 15. So 0.5 into 15 equal to the current profit, which is 31.5. Yes. Similarly, I'll update the current weight. Current weight of the knapsack will be whatever is earlier. Earlier it was 15. Plus 0.5 into 10. That is equal to 20. Right? So this is the current updated weight as well as the profit. And you can see current weight has now become 20. And your knapsack capacity is also 20. So I cannot fill any more objects. That's what I said. When I go for fraction selection, that is the last object that can be placed into the knapsack. So give a break statement. That means come out of your while loop. There's a while loop which keeps repeating, isn't it? Come out of the while loop. Now you can see here under x of 2. So the profit, the x value will now be 0.5. So you can see the x array. The x array tells fraction of the objects which are selected. X of 0 is 0. What does X of 0, 0 means? Means that first object is not selected. X of 1 is 1. Means what? Second object is completely selected. Next, X of 2 is 0.5. What does it mean? Third object is selected 50%. So 0.5 means 50%. Yes? So now that's the end of the while. So we have done with the selection process. So remember, what are you supposed to keep track here? And then once it has been done, I'll have to print which are all the items selected. What is the fraction that is selected? So system.out.println, item selected, the fraction selected, 0, 1 or partial. That is just a heading followed with one line of statements, right? And I've used a for loop. So what should I print? I should print the array x, because x holds, this is my solution vector. This tells me which are all objects selected, what fraction is selected, and my final profit value. Where is my final profit value? In CP, right? So I have to print that. And what is the weight of the knapsack after filling the objects, which is stored in CW. So I'll use a for loop here. I equals to 0, I less than in items I plus plus. System.out.println. I put one slash t, just formatting purpose, plus I plus 1. Why? Because I put I plus 1. Items selected, I put I plus 1 because you can see the index here starts with 0. So I usually while referring, we tell first object, second object, third object. We never tell it is 0th object, isn't it? Index is 0 in array, but for us it is first object. So while displaying also, I'll print first object only, which is at the index 0. So to print that, I use I plus 1. Okay, then concatenation operator plus two tabs plus what should I print? X, content of X, X of I. So I'll first print X of 0, then X of 1, then X of 2. So this 0 corresponds to first object, 1 corresponds to second object, 0.5 corresponds to third object. Yes, and finally, that's the end of the for loop. Only one statement is there. So we need to put braces. System.out.println. Maximum profit is CP. And the maximum weight of the knapsack after filling the objects is CW. That's the end of the fill function or fill method. Okay. So now we have to see what is getNext method doing. So as I told, getNext method will give me the index of the object or the item which has got the highest profit by weight ratio, right? How do we get that? Very simple it is. So I have two variables declared, max, which is initially 0, and it is of type double because all my weight, profit, ratio, they're all of type double, isn't it? Ratio is of type double, right? So it should be of type double. And index is equal to minus 1. Why I will not take 0 here is I have made a convention there. If index equals to minus 1, there are no objects in my knapsack. I cannot proceed further, right? There are no objects. So I will use this initial value of index equals to minus 1. So I will traverse my ratio array in this way. For I equals to 0, I less than ratio dot length. You can either use n items also. Ratio dot length, as you know, length is a property of an array which gives the length of the array or the number of elements in the array I plus plus. So I should select the maximum ratio. So if, how do I select it? If I am traversing the ratio array, isn't it? If ratio of I is greater than max, right? If for every value of I ranging from 0 to the length, if it is greater than max, update the max is equal to ratio of I and update the index equals to I. Very important. You should be very careful when you are doing this. So you should not update this as 1, right, by mistake. So that shouldn't happen. Okay. Update max equals to ratio of I as and index equals to I. Then the if, then the for. Once you get the maximum after traversing the entire array, return index, which gives the max value, right? That's the reason we said getNext returns the max index of the maximum ratio of the given items. And very important that you should note here is you should not replace this with any other variable or number. Okay, it should be I. Okay, by mistake also you should not do that. And here also by mistake also do not give some other initial value. So it is minus 1 because in my program I have used minus 1 indicates that if I return a minus 1 from getNext, it indicates that there are no more items in my store to select to the knapsack. So I'll break all. Okay. And the other thing which I should tell you here is compulsorily you have to make after selecting, you have to assign ratio of item equals to 0. Mark it as used for the getNext function, as I told you. Since I mark with 0, it will not be selected in the next iteration again as the highest, right? If you don't mark this with 0, in the next iteration also it will select 1.6 only as the highest. The index of 1.6 is what? 1. It will return 1 because highest is again 1.6. So my intention is in the first iteration, get next should select first highest. The next iteration, get next should select second highest. And next, we should go for third highest. Okay. That's how it has been done. As I have already told you all, this is one way of doing it. You can have the other ways of implementation too. One way I have just showing you the same. So let us go for the program execution part. Okay, this is our program, right? The same program I have taken, right? So the class with the constructor which reads the elements there and calculates the ratio too, and then get next function, right, which gets the index of the object which has got the highest max or the highest or the max ratio. And then fill, which fills the knapsack with the objects, right? And then the main method. Let us execute and see what do we get. The same problem which I had given as the input, we will give the same. Enter the objects in the store. So there are 3 objects. As I said, you have to enter the weight and the profit in the sequence order, right? So in the sequence order, you will have to just enter. First object weight is 18 and 25, right? The first object's weight is now 18 and the profit is 25. Same thing we'll give. And the next object's weight is 15 and the 24. Weight is 15 and the profit is 24. And the third object's weight is 10, space, profit is 15. You should give it in this way. First object weight followed with a profit. Give a space in between. Weight and profit space of the second object. Third object weight and the profit with a space. Re-enter it. 3 objects, 18 space 25, 15 space 24, 10 space 50. Capacity of the knapsack is 20. Okay. Okay. Is it printing 10? One second. We'll just look into this. So here I have given a single quote slash T. Okay, so you have to give in double quotes. Here. Okay, fine. Then execute the same. Okay. Number of object is 3. 18 space 25, 15 space 24, then 10 space 15, capacity of the knapsack is 20. My God, why is this? Some problem with the formatting. One second, I'll just format it. So we'll execute it. Some due to that online compiler, so it is taking some time to process. That will not be the issue if you are using Eclipse or the Fedora. Yes, you can now see the output. item selected and the fraction selected. First column is the items which are selected and what fraction is selected, whether it's 0, 1 or partial. Can you see the first object is 0, so it is not selected at all. Second object is selected completely and third object is selected 0.5. Can you see that? Right? So you can see the first object is not selected. Second object is fully completely selected. Then the third object is 0.5 selection process. And the maximum profit by obtained by selecting these two objects, the second is complete and the second is 0.5. So it will be 31.5 as the maximum profit. And since second is completely selected and the other one is, the third is half, you can see the weights are 50 and 10's half is 5, 15 plus 5. The current weight of the knapsack after placing the objects is 20. This is how it works. So you can work upon different inputs for the same, right? And also go through the problem there in a more precise way for the program and trace out for a particular input what can be the output. So you can see the same thing here. So first object is not selected, second object is fully selected, the third object is selected 0.5, same input. And you can also see you will get profit as 31.5 and the weight of the knapsack after all the objects are placed is 20. So be careful when you are dealing with the function. Get next is very important. So you should not make any mistake. And in fill, the very important aspect is making, after selecting, making that ratio of item equals to 0. So otherwise, you will select the same object every time in every iteration. Thank you.